Ngomong jujur, bumi wes ate acur, mau gak kena diatur, tipuper.
Wow. Starman? Mr. Starman? Oh, there's so much I want to ask you. So much, so much, so much. Where you came from and came. Oh, there's so much. Oh, there's. Mr. Starman, you're a very brave man.
Yes.
Do you?
No.
Please! What are you going to do when Pa comes into the woods this afternoon?
I will be gone.
Oh, there's...
Oh,
that's...
Thanks, places.
This afternoon at about 1 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, a mysterious message went out through Twitter and several other social media outlets. The message came from an unknown source through an unregistered, untraceable Twitter account. It is estimated that 1/3 of the world population has received this social media message. The message at first appeared to be nothing but the lyrics to a children's song, but by the end of the transmission, a series of coordinates in some kind of military-style code closed out the end of the broadcast. Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram claim that no message of this type was sent. Atman questioned if a military agency or an invading force of some kind could have taken over their networks was possible, all replied with, "No comment at this time." We'll be back after this.
People describe the Whopper by heart.
Flame grilled patty.
Pickles, tomatoes, onions.
Encanta. I'm getting hungry. Do you guys have a Whopper?
People crave what's real. And that's why we remove colors, flavors, and preservatives from artificial sources from the Whopper. Your way, way better.
Acura, in two words.
Mom, where are you? There you are.
Hi, sweetie.
Where? Oh, there you are. I couldn't see.
Hi.
Well, why do you have your mask on?
Hmm?
You have your mask on still. Hi.
Geez. Mary from down the street just left. I forgot I had it on.
Mary, of course. Why? She's always over. What is it now?
She got one of those emails.
What emails?
No, the ones that everybody's talking about.
Oh, the one with the other uncle in Nigeria. Yeah, I guess.
No. The one they're talking about on the news.
I've been at work all day in a bank with no TV. I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm sorry. It's been a terrible long day, and I'm just.
I got one of them too.
What? The emails?
Yeah, it's on emails, Facebook, tweeters, all that stuff.
Twitter, not tweeter, Ma.
Yeah. Here. Look, I mean, I don't know what it means.
Ma.
Nobody knows what it means, but I got one too.
Ma, I can't see what you're showing me. Can you just read it to me? Can you just tell me what it says?
No, I don't have it memorized.
Okay, I'm sorry. Listen, it's been a really bad day, and I've been dealing with nothing but a bunch of liars who don't care if who gets evicted or not. I just
no.
I'm not heartless. And just because I work for a bank that, you know, makes all the money in the world and just wants to make more, I you know, I care about people. I'm not heartless. I have a heart. You know, I care. And
light of the moon, bristlety, rosslety, hey Johnny, dotty, rickety, rackety. Rustical quality, willicky, wellicky, now.
Ma, what are you singing?
It's an old song. I Googled it.
Yeah, but is that the message that you got? Is that the message?
There's numbers at the end.
Ma, okay, but what does it mean?
I don't know.
It's kind of creepy.
I wouldn't worry about it.
Yeah, but you and Mary got it.
Yeah. They said on the news, well, lots of people got it.
But why you?
I don't know.
Okay, that's so weird.
You have a bad day?
Yeah.
Tomorrow will be better.
I know.
Just look on the bright side.
You always say that.
Yeah, well, it helps.
I know, you're right.
It helps to look on the bright side of things.
Even when they look dark.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Even when it looks dark.
Oh, I know. You're right, Mom. I know. You're right.
What's what?
Ma, are you sure that Mary went home?
Mary? Yeah, I already told you she went home.
Mom, get up. Run.
What are you
talking about? Get up, Mom. Let me dream my clothes.
No, get up! Mom, we're fine! Mom! Mom, answer me, please! Mom, answer me, where are you? Oh my god, Mom! Mom, please answer, please! Please, Mom, where are you? Oh my god, Mama, please! My mom's asking, please get away to my kid. I think she's been kidnapped again.
What is this, ma'am?
335 Boulder Drive. Please hurry.
What's your mom's name?
Sally Delport. Please get someone there. Please get someone there. Please hurry.
We have cars on route, ma'am.
I can't see her. I can't see her anymore. I can't see her.
Ma'am, what do you mean?
I was up, I had a video chat going with her, and now she's gone. She's just vanished. I am, but the singing. Shh, can't you hear the singing? Oh my god. My mama! Where's my mother? Please! Oh my god! Mama! Answer, mama! Where's my mother? Answer, mama!
What? What is it? What do you want? Whatever it is I did, I'm sorry, okay? Just let me go. We can work this out. I've got money. Money? Is it the money you want? Because I could take my debit card. We can go down to the bank and we can clean out the account. You can take it all. Nobody knows I have it. I promise. Nobody knows. Look, if I could just get to the bank. It's not the kind of my money that people miss, okay? It's, it's money that I took from other people. I don't know, I just wanted the money. Look, it's the kind of money that people will not report stolen, right? Nobody knows I have it. Look. I'm sorry, all right? If I took your money, I'm sorry. If I took your family's money, I'm sorry. All right, whatever it is I did to hurt you or your family, I am sorry, okay? I said I'm sorry. Look, man, I'm no good. I'm bad. I'm rotten. People pay me to be that way. People have paid me my whole life to do their dirty work. I'm bad. I'm bad. I'm rotten. I'm no good. I'm a bad seed. Whatever it is, however it is, you want to call it. But if you, if you set me loose, if you let me free, I promise I'll stop. I promise I will stop. What? 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 What did I do? What did I say? I said I was sorry, okay? I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Radio signals from space have been known to repeat, but for the first time over the last 3 days, scientists have noticed a pattern in a series of bursts coming from a single source, a half a billion light years from Earth. Fast radio bursts, or FRBs, are bursts of radio waves in space. Usually when these radio bursts repeat, it is sporadic or in a cluster, according to previous observations, but over the last 3 days, government scientists with the intensity mapping experiment at NASA have detected a pattern in bursts occurring every 72 hours, and over the course of 3 days, signal has tripled, stopped for 30 minutes, and then restarted, almost as if the bursts are repeating themselves. NASA will neither deny nor confirm the existence of these signals or from where they originate.
I'm documenting this because I live alone, and in case something were to happen to me, I want this to be left as evidence. I live within walking distance of Ground Zero, 9/11 Ground Zero. And for some reason, something else were to happen to me, I want my parents, who I love very much, to have an answer. Now, I've been watching for 6 hours now, and what began as a loud explosion and a ball of smoke hovering just over the horizon has now started to drift very slowly towards us. This thing, I'm calling it a thing because I can't make out what it is, it appears to be very large, hidden, cloaked in smoke. I don't know if you could see it. I tried taking pictures of it, but for whatever reason, its image cannot be captured. From where I am, it's right there. I could see it, especially between those two large buildings. It's right there. But for whatever reason, from where you are, through the lens of my phone, it can't be captured. It's not in any of the photos. It's not in any of the videos. From where I'm standing, it looks tremendous, but on camera, can you see it? I've lived in the desert. I've lived in the mountains. I've seen some weird shit, but this thing is strange looking. And what's even stranger is I can't take its picture. Now you've got some people walk out, stare right up at the sky. It's there. Others walk by, they don't even notice it. But the rest of the city has not stopped. I don't think they know this thing is up there. You would think it was like the sun or the moon or some celestial body. But it's not a celestial body. It's not any planet or star that we know, and yet I don't know why I can say that. I don't know why I'm even thinking it. Because we still don't know what this thing looks like. And maybe I'm fooling myself. Maybe I want to believe that this thing doesn't want to reveal what it really is, because it doesn't want us to know, because it's hiding in plain sight. And maybe the real invasion is happening somewhere else, and maybe people elsewhere on the planet are dying. But this thing just hovers up there, hiding behind its own smoke screen. I think we should run. I think we should get out of here. What's that? What is that? It sounds like it's coming over a loudspeaker. Or is it in my head? What does it mean? I want to run, but I can't. What is this?
You're home. Thank God. Are you packing?
No. Why would I be packing?
Did you see on the news?
Dude, I have shit to do. I've been cleaning all day and laundry, and finally, I just got a break to read my book.
Do you not pay attention to anything?
I'm sick and tired of listening to news about protests or the militia. I'm just not going to watch it anymore.
Sure, turn on the TV.
It's my break day, no media. You're lucky I answered the phone.
You don't know. I can't believe you don't know. Turn on the TV.
I don't want to. Why don't you just tell me?
It's an invasion. We're being invaded.
Who's being invaded?
The country. We are.
Hey, dude. If this is your way of telling me that you want another roommate and you found one already, there are better ways to tell me.
We have to get away from this thing.
What thing? There's nothing here. Everything is fine.
There's a thing out on the coast, and it's just floating there, and it keeps changing colors like it's sending out a signal, but they can't tell what it is yet.
Okay, well then how do they know that we're being invaded?
I don't know. They can't even take a picture of it.
Caitlin, if they can't take a picture of it, how do they know that it's there?
There's reporters and the news. They're just talking about it.
Wait. Have you seen it?
No.
Okay, well, do you want to go to the beach and see it?
No, what, are you crazy? This is bad. This is really bad.
What are we supposed to do? Leave town?
I'm coming home. Just get your valuables and start packing.
I don't have valuables. Besides, where are we going to go?
Palm Springs.
Your parents? Hell no.
Yes, just, you know, pack your shit and let's go.
Can't we just talk about this when you get home, okay? I have shit to do. Wayne's coming over. I'm not even ready yet. Just come home, okay?
Forget all of that, okay? We have to get out of here. It is not safe. It's really not safe.
Safe? What's not safe? Caitlin.
To an automatic voice message system.
Okay. Hello? Wayne, is that you? Since when are you early? I'm not even ready yet.
Faster, yeah.
But is it reliable?
Uh-huh, and secure.
You should consider making a big deal about it.
Bigger?
I said bigger.
Oh, bigger deal, bigger than what I'm doing?
It's not complicated. A 5G network needs a 5G device. Get the new Samsung Galaxy S20 FE 5G for free when you trade in.
Hey. You fell asleep with your sign again.
I fell asleep with your sign again. No, I didn't.
Okay.
Switch to Progressive and you can save hundreds. You know, like the sign says.
Nationally and locally, police departments are becoming overwhelmed with reports of what they call enforced disappearances. Victims of enforced disappearances are people who have literally disappeared from their loved ones and their community. They go missing when state officials or someone acting within the state grabs their loved ones from the street or from their homes, and then they deny it or refuse to say where they are. Sometimes disappearances may be committed by armed non-state actors or political opposition groups. Victims are often never released and their fate remains unknown. It is believed that victims are possibly being tortured and that many are killed or being kept alive in constant fear of being killed. Victims probably know their families have no idea where they are and that there is little chance anyone is coming to help them. Even if the victim does escape death and are eventually released, the physical and psychological scars of enforced disappearances stays with the victims and their families for the rest of their lives. Experts also believe this influx of missing persons may be caused by the mass hysteria surrounding the reports of strange sightings of smoking objects in the atmosphere that have not been substantiated or proven at this time. We'll be back after these messages.
Every stroke she shed a tear, wristledy, rustledy, hey Johnny, dostledy, nickety, knackety, willicky, wallicky, rustic quality, now. She swept the floor, but once...
Amber?
Jason?
You all right?
Where are you?
I'm still at work.
Why aren't you, why get there? Hurry, Jason.
Okay, calm down, slow down. Your messages didn't make any sense. Well, what about the police?
Thank God, I haven't heard back from them. I don't know, they should be there by now. I haven't heard back.
Did they come talk to you?
No, they're not helping, and I don't know why.
All right, I'm on my way.
No, don't come here. Why would you come here? Go to Mom's. Why would you come here?
Because it doesn't make any sense.
Why Mom? Why us?
What?
Why my mom? Why would anyone take Mom?
I don't know.
I don't understand.
Are you positive what you saw?
Of course I know what I saw. Of course I'm positive what I saw.
Okay. Calm down. I'm heading over there now.
No, Jason.
Yeah.
I'm scared.
What? I couldn't hear you.
I'm scared. I'm
scared. My phone's breaking up. I couldn't hear a word you're saying.
Jason, hello? Please.
Hello?
Jason, no, hello? Jason. No. I don't know. Jason, please. What do I do? What do I do? Please. Oh, God, please. Jason. Please. Please, Jason, please answer me.
been halfway there. You've wasted all this time. All this time wasted. Hello?
Home?
Yes, we're still home.
What are you doing? I thought you were coming to get me. I thought you were leaving.
It's not me. It's your father.
Daddy, what?
He doesn't want to leave.
Ma, why?
He doesn't want to leave. Wait, who doesn't want to leave?
Can you put him on?
It's our son.
Give me the phone.
What, you're going to tell him why we're abandoning him? Why we're not on our way up to get him?
Donnie.
Dad, are you coming or not?
No, we're not.
Are you crazy? Why not?
Just calm down.
Well, I'm scared. I want to get out of here.
You're safer there on campus than you can be anywhere out in the world right now.
Dad, what are these things on the coast? And people are vanishing. I mean, we just heard about people knocking on people's doors.
All of that is true. Yes, I've heard all of that, but it's not what it seems to be. This is not what you think it is.
I don't understand.
Your campus is on lockdown, right?
Yeah, no one can get in. We can only get out if our parents show up and sign us out.
Okay, so then you're safer there than you could be anywhere with us right now.
Why is this happening?
I'm not sure.
That is not what you just said. You just said this is not what you think.
Okay, what is it? Dad, I'm really scared.
I know you are, man. Look, we're really scared too, okay? But you've got nothing to be scared about, all right? You're over an hour from the coast, okay? You are on a lockdown campus in a locked dorm with a cafeteria in the basement. You have everything you need, right?
Yeah, kinda, I guess.
Look, son, just stay there where it's safe, okay? And when this is all over and we figure out what's happening, we'll come and get you out of there. I don't think it's safe to travel right now. I mean, no one is on the freeways. The airplanes are not flying. Just hang tight, okay? And when this is all over and we know what's what, we'll get you out of there.
I just don't understand. I guess you're right.
I know I'm right.
I love you.
Oh, we love you too.
I'll call you later.
Yeah, we'll call you.
Okay.
Oh, and Donnie.
Yeah.
You're gonna be all right, okay? We're all gonna be all right.
Okay.
All right, bye.
Bye.
I cannot believe you.
He'll be safer. And you're not?
Give me your keys.
Why?
I'm taking your car.
No, you're not.
Yes, it is new. It's an SUV. I'm taking
it. I don't care.
I am not abandoning our son.
And neither am I. If we go up there, we'll never make it back.
So what?
This is our home.
Oh, our house. That's what this is about?
It's an invasion.
You don't know that.
Oh, well, things are changing, all right? People are vanishing from their homes. Ask yourself why.
I don't care why.
Oh, because that's how it starts, right? You don't care about what's going on around you. And then before you know it, you don't care what people think about you. And you stop thinking about what people are saying about you. And then you don't care when they ask you to change your clothes or when they won't let you buy any food. And not long after that, you're hiding in some attic. In some crawl space, your life exists in some cellar, in some attic somewhere. No one knows where you are until they come and find you. I'm not going out that way. This is our home. I've been afraid of this my entire life, and I promised myself that I wouldn't surrender anything when it came my time to go. I'm not going out like that.
I understand all of that, but I'm going to get my son.
Where are you?
Don't you ever just say hello?
I'm playing Warzone right now. Where are you? I thought you were going to be my wingman on this.
I am. But look, three times I got this.
Oh, dude, did you just see that? I just headshotted that noob.
Now it's four. Hey, I got four of these emails now.
From who?
I don't know. I don't recognize the email address.
Well, what's it say?
Kitsch@mystery.com?
No, not the address, the email. Oh, shit. Oh, I just got him with a pistol. You freaking idiot.
Hey, can you hit pause?
No, the circle's about to close. Come on. What does the email say?
I'm not opening it. I'm afraid to open it.
Oh, just open it.
You know what's happening, right?
I don't believe any of it.
None of it.
I mean, what? Spaceships that no one can photograph? People disappearing in the middle of the night? I mean, Men in Black appear because of some nursery rhyme? What's the rhyme? Baba Black Sheep?
I don't know. Look, I don't want to chance it, okay?
Oh my gosh, just open the email.
What do you even know about it? You probably haven't even, like, left that gaming chair all fucking day.
Oh my god, I gotta get to the circle and I'm pinned down. You gotta be fucking kidding me right now.
Hey, hit pause, player one!
What do you want?
I'm scared. Look, why do they want me?
They don't. Just open it and don't sing it out loud.
Really?
I do turn on the news sometimes.
Okay, but you're my witness. I married my wife in the month of June, Rizzledy Rosaldy.
Stop. Don't read the rest. What else is on the email?
Just the words to the song, and then there's a set of numbers at the end.
Okay. Screenshot me a copy of the email. Let's break the chain. So don't email a thing, send it phone to phone.
Okay. Done.
Got it. I see the numbers.
Anything you recognize?
Probably a code.
You think?
We both know.
Codes are meant to be cracked.
All right. I'll start with Crowbar and Arrow Crack. You take Medusa and Rainbow Crack.
Good. I love Rainbow Crack.
Up and running.
Me too.
Wait a minute.
What?
No way.
No way what?
It can't be this easy.
What's easy?
Somebody should have found this by now.
Are you going to tell me already? Jeez.
Take the first set of numbers, divide it in half, and then take the square root.
Map coordinates?
Mm-hmm. One's longitude and the other is?
Latitude.
After you do the math.
Damn.
Diego Garcia.
Who's he?
He's a what? An island near the Philippines.
So all these people vanishing and now they're on an island?
No, but there's a conspiracy theory that says that Diego Garcia...
Wait. I hate conspiracy theories.
Okay, well, some people think that Malaysia Airlines Flight 370 landed on Diego Garcia.
It's got nothing to do with them sending me an email.
Well, some people believe that all the passengers on that flight are still alive, and because there's a major U.S. military base on the island, that the U.S. of A. kidnapped the plane and all of its passengers to make it look like a terrorist attack.
Kidnapped?
Kidnap people then. Kidnap people now.
Yeah, that's a link.
And the passengers' cell phones were pinging for weeks after the disappearance. So some people think that the passengers are still alive and others.
Others what?
Others think it's some kind of vortex, an entryway or exit way to outer space or even inner space.
Thank you.
Sorry. It's a control by mistake.
We should tell someone.
Who are we going to tell?
The government? The cops? Someone.
What if they're behind all this?
No way.
I mean, why not? Wouldn't be the first time that a government made its citizens disappear.
X?
Yeah?
This is big. Really big.
We cannot get involved, right? We could leave here. There's places to hide.
Yeah, but then...
Who is it? Who is it?
It's blocked.
Don't answer.
What if they got my parents?
Your parents are in San Francisco.
Yeah, but people have vanished in San Fran too.
Oh my God, please don't answer it. Peppermint, hang up the phone. Hang up the phone, Peppermint. Stop the phone. Stop. Stop the phone. Stop!
The FBI is assisting local authorities with the floods of investigations into the disappearances of friends and family members in the U.S. and Mexico. Several victims have vanished without a trace, according to family members who said they have not heard from their loved ones since the day they reported them missing. All cell phones of the missing family members have gone dead and are unable to be pinged or traced. Family members have been told that they believe there could be foul play involved. The FBI confirmed it is assisting in these investigations, but did not give further details. The FBI also refused comment when asked if the family members are connected to reports of floating objects along the coast and several southern border cities. In the state of Indiana, 12 Indiana University students have gone missing, the first missing group in America, according to authorities. The students between the ages of 19 and 21 vanished after spending the early morning partying at a downtown bar in Bloomington, Indiana. Several of the students were last seen walking outside a classmate's off-campus apartment around 4:30 in the morning. The missing group, along with all other missing U.S. citizens, has sparked a national manhunt, prompting several celebrities, including comedian Stephen Colbert and reality star Kim Kardashian, to spread awareness about the disappearances on social media. Investigators have still been unable to locate any missing victims, and millions of tips have led to dead ends. Meanwhile, a group of the missing students' parents are sending out heartfelt video messages over Facebook with the hope that someone will come forward with information about their missing children.
On the upper hands, special guest Flo challenges the hat models to show off the ease of comparing rates with Progressive's Home Court Explorer. International hand model John John gets personal.
Your wayward pinky is grotesque.
Then, a high-stakes patty cake battle royale ends in triumph.
You have the upper hand.
It's a race to the lowest rate and so much more. Only on the upper hands.
It's not a competition. It's just that you're not willing to settle. Not in your work, not in your hobbies, and never with your bourbon. Evan Williams. Bourbon done right.
Where is the car key?
I don't understand the digging. Michael, which hole has the car key in it?
Come on, I don't want to be late to this.
We're going to have a little talk when I get back.
It's a good thing you're cute.
Killing me, man.
A better take on the spare key. The all-new Elantra with Hyundai Digital Key.
Old Dominion puts together a winning performance with precision, a number one ranking in claims prevention, Japan by going the distance to become number one in customer satisfaction. Old Dominion, official freight carrier of Major League Baseball.
Every day, Lord, every day in this thing that is happening, I look to see where I can be of some good. Where can I do your work? Where can I do your bidding? I can't find a place to do your work. People are vanishing daily. Are they dead? Where do they go? No one knows. No one knows but you. Is it an invasion, an enemy we cannot see, an enemy amongst us? I do not know. Only you know. That is why I come to you. Yesterday, it came to me. I found an answer, and that is why I'm here today. I found a story, one I had forgotten, one that I was taught many years ago. July 29th, 1941. One of the commanders in the Nazi death camp, Auschwitz, he sent 10 men to die in the notorious camp starvation bunker. One of those men, a sergeant in the Polish army and father of two, burst into tears. That made Maximilian Kolbe approach the camp commander. I am a Catholic priest from Poland. I would like to take his place. The camp commander accepted the offer, and the priest went to Auschwitz's notorious starvation bunker with the other 9 inmates whom he tried to console. 2 weeks later, Kolbe and 3 of the other prisoners who were still alive were finished off with gas. Their bodies were burned. Lord, every day they vanish. Fathers, mothers, the young, the old, and they never return. Our way of life is being taken from us. Where are they taken to? What awaits them after they're taken from their homes? Why is this happening? I've been asking this for days and nothing. No answer. And yesterday, you remind me of Saint Maximilian Kolbe, the priest that saved lives. God, I am a Catholic priest from the United States of America, and I would like to take their place. Someone's place, anyone's place. Let them take me. Oh God, my Lord, is that you?
Hello? Are you there? Okay, I'm parking my car right now.
Yeah, I'm hiding. I think they're gone.
Who's gone?
I don't know. I can't see them.
Them?
Yeah, they're all covered in black. I can't see their faces. Just be quiet, please.
Okay, I know. I mean, they said that on the news, so.
Wait, people know?
Everybody knows.
I don't understand. Please be quiet.
No one does.
They took my mom, and they took my mom, and then they came for me.
I know. Okay, I'm coming up the stairs right now, okay?
But please, sure, make sure you're alone. Make sure no one's following you, okay? Mari, please answer me. Mari, oh my God, Mari, please. Mari, please answer me. I'm scared. Mari, where are you? Mari, where are you?
I'm here. Just calm down, where are you?
Okay.
Are you sure no one followed you?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. know anything. Are you sure?
The government is being weird, but when are they not weird?
Okay. Have they taken anyone important?
Important?
Like kings, queens, prime ministers, presidents, like anyone like that?
No, I mean, I haven't heard anything like that.
I can't do this. Why can't I fucking... Okay. It's still on the camera. My mom's house, it's still there. My brother Jason, he should be there by now to check on the house with the police. I told the cops to send someone, and I don't know if they did. It happened all right here, just right in front of me. And I told her to go, and I couldn't do anything to help her. I told her to get up and run, and I couldn't help her.
It's okay. There's nothing anybody could have done unless they were there with her. It's okay. We're gonna figure this out. Calm down.
No.
I think we should get you out of here.
Where will we go?
Okay, we can go to Jason's place. We can go to the cops. Let's just get you out of here.
Is it safe? Yeah?
Outside? I mean, when was the last time anybody felt safe outside?
Okay, I know.
Wait, why don't you go pack a bag, okay? Right? Do the cops at least call you back?
No, I haven't heard from them. I don't understand. Jason should be there by now. I mean, why my mom? Why would anyone take my mom? I mean, she's not involved in politics or government or anything. I mean, yeah, my dad worked for aerospace companies, but he's been dead so long. None of this makes any sense. I don't know what I'm doing.
You just wanted what? Amber? What's wrong?
These out of your purse. Why do you have them?
Well, you weren't supposed to see that.
They're yours?
Mm-hmm.
Why do you have them?
You know why.
You're with them?
I am them.
What do you want?
Why are you asking me questions that you already know the answers to?
I don't know any of the answers. What is it and why?
Change. Change in the natural order.
By kidnapping?
Who's kidnapping?
What?
We're not doing anything that hasn't already been done before on this planet.
I don't understand.
Okay. This is the time, okay? For change.
What kind of change?
Change that makes more sense.
No, it doesn't.
You know what? Change is hard. Okay, Amber?
I don't want to.
Well, nobody wants to.
Please. Please, Mom. Please don't. Mom. Please don't. Mom.
I'm sorry.
Mom.
If you've looked up at the night sky recently, you might have been surprised to see objects of bright, multicolored lights hovering and changing colors. And if you attempt to capture the image with a camera or on your cell phone, well, there is no image, so what's going on? The lights appear in multiple groups in diamond-shaped patterns, and they have been cited in numerous reports from places like the U.S., Mexico, and the United Kingdom. And people have seen them with explanations ranging from UFOs to an alien invasion. But fear not. These lights are actually satellites launched into space by the US company SpaceX. And they're a... they're a new experiment that... No, you know what? I can't. You know, they want me to say that these lights are nothing but a new series of multiple satellites being launched, but that's what they want me to say. These are cover stories. They're sent out to confuse you and pull your attention. You know, we are being told, do not believe what you see, and what you're seeing is an alternate truth. But what is an alternate truth. I mean, what happened to the real truth? I can only tell you what I know as a member of an organization that was meant to report, observe, and do so with integrity. There is no so-called invasion. We're being duped. People, our loved ones, people from all walks of life are being abducted and taken away. And why? You know, they want me to report people are missing and the enemy, our enemy, is some kind of an alien from outer space. But our enemy is real. Our enemy is here. And this enemy knows that the real danger is it's not out there, but in here, in each of us. They disarm us by use of a children's song, a song that puts humans into a trance-like state, and then they show up, rip us out of our homes. Now. There, I said it. Now, has a message. But is it woven behind the words? Or is it really deep down inside of us? You know, after World War II, people asked, how did these atrocities happen? I mean, who allowed this to happen? We all allowed this. In fact, some of us even welcomed it. As of this day, I will not allow this to happen to me or my family. And as of this day, I will no longer let my government, my religion, my society sweep me up in a roundup and forcibly throw me into the back of a truck and take me to a camp. As of today, I am fighting back. So I say, save yourselves. Push back, fight back. Do not get dragged off into the night. We are better than this. You are better than this. And I know for a fact that I am better than this. I'm going home.
Thus saith the Lord, this country shall be left without a responsible leader. We will destruct the government in a manner that they will not be able to fulfill their governmental duties. It will be such a distress that the people of this nation will arise and will try to join in groups for self-protection. Mob rule will reign in many places, and there shall be a great sickness, a sickness that shall pollute the air and the soil. Destroy many souls. Our path is clear, and our work is successful. Welcome, all representatives, before our next transmission. Stand by for roll call. Please acknowledge upon request. Representative of the Central Division.
Central Division.
Representative of the Southwest Center Division.
Southwest Central Division.
Representative of the East Coast Division.
East Coast Division.
Representative of the Pacific Division.
Pacific Division.
Representative of the Central West Side Division.
Central West Side Division.
Representative of the Rocky Mountain Division.
Rocky Mountain Division.
representative of the Southwest Division.
Southwest Division.
Representative of the Great Lakes Division.
Great Lakes Division.
Representative of the Mid-Atlantic Division.
Mid-Atlantic Division.
Representative of the
Chris Neri, Man in Black.
What's up? Alexa Wadd, playing one of the Men in Black. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Heidi Schuler. I played Weaseldy Rosaldy, Ghost Girl. Hey.
I'm Fat Girl Serene, playing the role of Peppermint.
Hi, my name is Ryan Joseph Murphy, and I play the role of X.
Hi, I'm Harry Fawn, and I play Donnie.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Fawn, and I play the part of Arthur.
Hi, I'm Jenny Fawn, and I play the role of Joni.
You did.
Hi, I'm Victoria Polito, and I played the role of Caitlin.
Hi, Anita Lehman Torres, playing Diane.
Christina!
I'm Christina Oriano, and I played Tracy.
Hi, I'm Jack Zulo. I played the role of Jake. Robert DiTilio.
Hi, I'm Robert DiTilio. I played the role of the priest.
Christine.
Hi, I'm Christine DiTilio, and I play the role of Sally Dalport.
Sapna.
Hi, I'm Sapna Gandhi, and I play the role of Mari.
Allison.
Hi, I'm Allison Zerboff, and I play the role of Amber.
And Bob Telford.
Hi, I'm Bob Telford, and I play the role of news anchor.
Everybody!
Now was written and directed by Tom Cavanaugh. We would like to thank We Make Movies for presenting this production. Now, from the entire Now team, we thank you for tuning in. And we hope you have a very good night.